So this is the locking mechanism right here. Hey guys, welcome to Car Garage. Today I'm going to show you guys my new toy. I've got an upgrade for my hydraulic jack. So I've ordered a Quickjack Bl-7000Slx. Capable of carrying 7,000 pounds. Truck SUV. So this is what came from the delivery company. It was pallet. All together was in one pallet, but I ended up breaking it down into pieces so I can bring it down, so I didn't have to pay for extra charges if I had to use the lift gate. So this second box, first box, and this is probably the motor. Alright, so there you go. I'm going to assemble it today, and I'm going to show you guys how it is when it's ready for some job. Okay guys, Quickjack. Okay, here you go guys, I've opened up this one box, and it looks like it's well packaged. Here's the list of the things that's supposed to be in all the box. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna go through the listings, see if I have everything. Lego block. Hydraulic hoses, hardwares, more locks, this looks like the motor. Alright, so this is what came in this box. I'm gonna open this up, see what's inside. So we got small blocks and the big blocks. Total of 8. 4 small, 4 big. Okay, so this box comes in Lugo Environmental Protection Type. It's a thread sealant. Fittings. And quick connect. To the next one. So this is the first one I open, which is the right side, and this will be the left side. Box number one is the left side, box number two is the right side. So I'm going to open this one. Hanger for this. So, let's go ahead and hang it like that on the wall. Alright guys, so I'm looking at the list here. Just checking out what I received. So, power unit, four tall rubber pads, four short rubber pads, two short hose assembly, and long hose. We got the assembly kit. And the frame positioning handles. And of course, two frame positioning adjusters. And my wall hanger. Okay, looks like everything is here, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this all together. Gasket side. So I actually want to have it facing this way because that's where the hose, the short hose is going to run through underneath. I'm going to have to face it that way. And now all I have to do is tighten it. Size 18 wrench and grab a 14 mil. Just to hold that. And just wrenching it. grab the short hose. So that's the male side. So then obviously you're gonna wanna put the female side on this side. I'm good. So I use 17, 18 just to hold this. Okay, well, pardon me. Now we're on to this side. Now we're gonna connect a quick connect here. Don't worry. So this is the quick connect. There you go. So this female side will connect to the short hose. And this is the quick connect side. We'll connect to the long hose. Okay? Now before you put this on, we're gonna put some sealant. This is a 3 sealant that came with the box. Came in with the package, so you want to just put them on and you can install it. Okay. I'll go ahead and put some sealant in. This is actually an upgraded sealant because what they have in the manual is a sealant tape. And they'd want you to apply the sealant tape in clockwise direction, like the way how you're tightening the fittings. But in this case, this is liquid type, so use it sparingly. So I'm gonna go ahead and spread it all around the threads, and I'll make sure that that's dry. There's no sealant that gets through there, otherwise it's going to block the fluid. Then I'll go ahead and connect the female side to the small holes. There it is. Then I'll have my 22 mil wrench here. And 17 mil wrench here. Put it right there, so nice and clean. And this. Alright, so here I have the long hose here, so I'm going to have to connect all quick connect on this side and on this end. So this end here, and the other one will go to this one. Okay. Go ahead and apply some sealant on both sides. I'll go one by one. Side. And again, find this. One. Second one. Sealant. Go. Okay, now I'm going to show you guys how to connect. This together. This is the long hose. This is the short hose. that look like. I just want to push it in like that and to lock it up. You basically want to turn this away from the ball. So you want to take it off. See the ball here? That's the ball there. There you go. Take it off. You want to put it in like that. Turn it away from the ball. Any side. Okay. Take it up, line to the ball, press it, okay, there you go. Take it off once again. It's not going anywhere. It's tight there. Okay. Okay, guys, so there's this last fitting that I'm gonna put. This will go to the power unit. So in the instruction it tell you to do the bottom first, and I've already done that. And I'm gonna put the second one, the one on top, so it's a red cap. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove this and screw this in. There's a O-ring gasket in here, so this side up. This side will go into the power unit. Just like so. Go. Okay, just like that. Okay, guys, just to recap here. So the installation is done for both sides. Short hose. So that goes underneath. Like so, and then quick connect, and then comes the long hose, right? Same thing on the other side here. Comes down there, short hose, quick connect hose to the long hose, and I'm going to connect the long hoses to the power unit. Lock it up. It's locked. Other side. Lock. Okay, that's not going anywhere. Alright guys, so the installation is done. So basically the next step now is to fill up the tank with hydraulic fluid or ATF. I'm gonna have to open the reservoir cap here. And I'm gonna check if there's fluid inside. Because when I removed the red cap here, there was fluid coming out. So I don't know whether there is some fluid filled to that just a little bit, because in the instruction manual it says it's empty, so I'm going to open the cap and see if there's any liquid in there. Okay guys, so I removed the cap. This cap, by the way, is the vent type cap. It's not the other one. Alright, so you guys can see there's no fluid inside, so I'm gonna go and fill this up with ATF. Okay, guys, the setup is already done. We've already connected all the lines. Cylinder is filled with 45 psi, put 45 psi. The range is 40 to 50 psi maximum. Okay. Put some rags here just in case. In a leak, appears to be one. There you go. And I'm gonna go plug this in, and we're ready to lift this Quickjack up. Okay. Okay, guys. So everything's set up already, and we're gonna go and try it out. We're gonna press the up button. We're gonna see how it goes, but first I'm gonna show you guys what I put here. So I put the adapter extender for the trucks. I bought that also. It came in with this package. You gotta buy this separately. Alright, on both sides. And now we're gonna lift it up. Alright, go up. So this is the locking mechanism right here. You'll hear the first lock when you hear it click. That's the first lock. So basically, if you want to lock it, just go down. And if you want to go down, lift it up like that, and it will go down. So that's the lock when you go down, right? So you gotta go past the locking mechanism, and then lift this up like so, and then go down. I want to show you guys how high this car is gonna go. Okay, go up,
up,
up, please, all the way up. Okay, down to lock it up.
Down.
So you basically don't need to do anything because it's already in locking position. So then all you have to do now is go down. Okay, go down. Down. There you go. So that's locked. Nakalock dito, nakalock. So what we can do is check the stability of the vehicle. Make sure that's not going anywhere. So this is the other side. Pretty solid, guys. Okay. It's neat. Alright, to go down, you want to raise up the vehicle. Go up.
Up.
Up. Okay. Stop. And then you want to push that up like so. So this one will lay on this curvature, right? So it will go like that. Do the same thing on the other side. So I'm going to lift this up, just lay it flat on its curve there. So now we can go down. Down. Show you guys how the locking mechanism is gonna go through the lock there. So it just went through it, there you go. Excellent, bravo. Quickjack 7000SLX. I'm happy about it. It's really good. Setup is pretty easy and straightforward, and there's no leak. Well, thank you. There's no leak on the quick connect. You guys can see over there. That's the quick connect. There's no leak. The other side, there's no leak. So if you use this thread sealant LG188 that comes in the package, you won't have any problem with the leak. Because I know I watch a few videos online when they assemble everything and when the start using the Quickjack, they have a problem with the leak, and now they've already found a solution to that, and this is it right here, LG188 Lugo. It's a thread sealant. Alright, okay guys, thanks for watching.